Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you what's on my iPhone because you guys are always requesting this video. Even though I did one like a few months ago, you guys seem to request a new one like every month. So I've actually been putting this video away for a little while just because my phone doesn't change every month. But I recently changed it up quite a lot from the last one, downloaded some new apps. So today I'm gonna show you what's on my iPhone for spring 2019. Let's get started. Could use this for the video. Okay, thank you. No, thank you. So if you watched my previous What's My iPhone videos, you probably know what my phone looks like, but this is the phone anyways. It's an iPhone XS Max and in gold, obviously. As you can see, right now I just have this clear case on it. It's from the Apple Store, Tech 21. It's really protective and just simple. And I made a shopping vlog of this a while ago, so I will link that in the description in case you want to go and check it out. Alright, but now let's get started on what's on my iPhone. So this is my background. It's just a picture of my dog. I just love it because I love her and I just love the summer vibe of it. And then when you go into the phone, this is what you see on the first page. I also like that the background is like really colorful because I feel like that just goes well with spring and summer. So first I have Snapchat. I can't really show you actually my room because I recently redid my room and I haven't done a room tour yet. That's coming in my next video, by the way. Well, anyways, Snapchat. That's just for my friends. I haven't opened Snapchats before the whole morning. We can snap some people. Oh wait, he did answer. Oh. Snapchat is probably my most used app. Yeah. It's like what I use for connecting, talking to my friends. Then I have Instagram. Instagram is probably my second most used app. So my Instagram is simply Sophia's, in case you want to go check it out. I think you should. A little while ago, I just like got really tired of Instagram. I don't know, I just didn't feel like it was a fun place to come to. I just felt like it was posting useless pictures. But now I think it's kind of fun again because I love to edit pictures and just like post them. Yeah, I don't know. All right, and then I have Pinterest. Love to go in here to get inspiration. So when I was redoing my room, I created this folder called like New Room and I just had a bunch of inspiration for my room that I could like go after when I was redoing my room. And then you have one dresses. Just have like prom dresses too. So beautiful. By the way, stay tuned for prom videos. I'm not going to prom, but I'm making prom videos. Alright, and then I have a folder called photo and video. And here you just have my editing apps for Instagram. Not only for Instagram, Fonto I use for thumbnails. I show this in like every single one of my videos, but if you take this picture, you can just like basically create these really Tumblr aesthetic pictures, I guess. And then you have VS Code, which is what I use mainly for editing my Instagram pictures in. So I could actually show you like how I edited this picture. So now I have like a preset of what I usually use for editing my pictures, but I use the filter L7 normally like to get some more warmer tones, or I also use C6, or yeah, well, these ones are my favorite filters. Lower the skin tones a little bit and add some grain, go up with highlights. So really simple, but that's what I do for my pictures. Then I just have my camera roll. Here's, no wait, I can't show that. Here's, basically can't show anything, but yeah. And then I have my camera, yeah, that's the camera. And then you have Anam, which is an Instagram planner app. I use it to plan my feed. Like, this is actually really good because I was not sure whether I should post this picture in black and white or color. But then I was like, it looks so much better in black and white to my feed. And then I have an editing app called Focus. And this one is like really great for creating these blurry backgrounds. You just like drag this up to get the blur you want. And then you can also choose the shapes. Make a bokeh effect basically. You can like adjust the font bokeh and everything's like really advanced. And then you have an app called Ultralight. I use this one for filters. I really like Nature 2 one. And then it has my all-time favorite black and white filter. This one. It just like takes the highlights down a lot. Looks amazing on sunset pictures. And then Darkroom. It's also a bunch of filters. And then Unfold. Basically, it's for creating stories. So you can just like add a bunch of pictures and create a story for your Instagram. And then 9067 is like a bunch of these cool effects. And I really like this one. These are the only free ones. Then there's a bunch of ones you can buy. And then I have an app called Carbon. Not sure what it is because I got this yesterday. Oh, it's a bunch of black and white filters. Great for choosing just the right black and white filter. And then they also have like some textures. It's like dust, grain, bokeh. And that's all my editing apps. Actually not, but that's like the editing apps I use. We're gonna come to a second editing app folder. And then you have settings. That's just settings. And Safari, weather. We don't even gotta check that. The weather today is awful. It was snowing today. It's supposed to be spring. And then you have a folder called productivity. And here you just have calendar, reminders, notes, wonder list, which is like, basically you can just create lists. So I have a to-do list, looks really good right now, but doesn't really show the truth. And then you have drive and docs. Which I use for both school and like planning YouTube videos, basically anything, writing scripts and stuff. And then you have Gmail and then clock. Well, and then you have maps, which I use for finding my way to places. And then down here, I have phone, messages, and so Spotify. Am I the only one who still has the same playlist as I had? 2010. This is the best song to ever exist. Wait. Except Whatever It Takes. It's like, it's a great song, but you gotta listen to like in a car. Like, this is gonna be my summer song. In the airplane, fly New York to Jamaica, setting the party on fire, taking you higher and higher. And then Billie Eilish, I've listened to her like non-stop. I'm so gonna get copyrighted, but it's for you, Billy. Oh, so. I could actually make a whole video of my playlist. Actually, I think I'm gonna do that this summer. But moving on to okay, then moving on to the second page. Here I have a YouTube folder. So you just have the YouTube app, YouTube Studio, Social Blade, FameBit, and Thumbnail Maker. Usually I do this on the computer, but I just thought it was good to also have the app. I really like this feature that you can like have two photos and a thumbnail. And then I have some more editing apps, and these are basically apps that I normally don't use, but I still don't want to like delete them. But I'm not really gonna go into it because it's just gonna take a while. And yeah, I also have TikTok here. You can go and check out my TikTok if you want to. I haven't posted in no, I can't show that. I haven't posted in like a few months. It's just like I don't really think TikTok is fun anymore. I loved Musical.ly, but TikTok is not the same thing. And you're the cutest. She has the coolest eyes. Think about 100 guys. And then I have a travel folder where I just have Google Maps. I don't really get the difference between Google Maps and Maps. It's like, except the Google thing is like the same thing. And then I have SAS, which is like a Scandinavian Airlines. It's just a flight app. And then I have a bunch of usable apps. So just a bank app, Swish app. I've gotten a Swish. Wow. And then bank IG, mail. And then the app store. If you like have any app suggestions, comment down below. Because I want to know. And then I have the calculator, basic calculator. Currency, which is for, because you guys won't understand if I speak in Swedish, money. And then a radio app, Primetime, this is a good one. It's like a live quiz game. And then Netflix, I also need to start watching Netflix more. And then I just have a bunch of news app and a driver's practicing app. So yeah, that's it on the second page, and then on the third page, I've like organized them from what I use the most. So on the first page, that's like what I use the most, and then on the second page, what, yeah, second and third page, I basically never use these apps. So I have a few watch apps for the Apple Watch, and then I have some shopping apps. I just deleted a bunch of shopping apps because I wasn't using them. So these are my favorite stores. I never shop on like actual apps. I just like to go through them and find inspiration. And then I have school apps. So Classroom, Quizlet. Quizlet is really great if you want to learn some new words. I use it for Spanish. Impaciente. Pass. And then dictionary, just like an English dictionary. Kahoot, we love Kahoot. Duolingo, student card. Math 42, this one is really great if you have a math problem and you just want to solve it. It's basically like a calculator, so you can just like type in the problem. And you can also like find some basics if you just need a quick explanation to a bunch of things in math. And then I have Khan Academy, which is also like a learning app. So they have a bunch of subjects, like basically any subject. So we can have like economics and then macroeconomics. And they have like basically anything here. Supply and demand. It's just like a bunch of free classes. Like it's basically going to school, but you can do it yourself. You should try it because it's great. And then you have an app called Bookly, supposed to track your how much you're reading, and I'm trying to read more, so I thought it would be good. And this is my analytics. Haven't read a single book since I started. You can put up a goal and then see the statistics of that, I guess. And then I have an app called Peak, and that is for training your brain. So it's like problem solving, practicing your memory, language, and focus. It has some workouts every day. We can try one. Okay, so this is a memory game. Let's see my memory. I think this is going pretty good. It's a like good time consuming game if you're ever bored and just want to do something like still productive, not play Candy Crush. Then you have a folder called health. So I have TED Talks, which, yeah, it's not really health. More like education. Let's move on. Then you have health, elevate. This is also like brain training. And then I have an app called Grateful, but I've used it like too much, so I can't use it more without paying for it. But it just like basically asks you what you have been grateful for today and stuff like that, so you can write down and like reflect on your day. But you can also like just write that down on a piece of paper, so. And then I have an app called Meditation, which is meditation, and I don't meditate, but I started with this yesterday because I'm like, I can never go to sleep. My mind is like just up and running, so I thought this would be good because it's supposed to like both help you focus more and help you fall asleep faster. And it actually like worked yesterday. It worked. I did this at like 9 o'clock, but that was probably a little too early for doing this because I got so tired. But then I kept myself awake, and then like at 11, when I was supposed to go to bed, I was up and running again. I'm gonna keep doing it. They have like an introduction program for 10 days, so I'm gonna do that and see how it works. Okay, and then in the last folder I have, it's called Rest. So it's a bunch of rest apps, extra apps, basically apps that I don't use. So yeah, I'm not gonna go through them. I think, why am I not deleting these? Maybe I just should delete them. Well, and that's everything on my iPhone. So I really hope you liked seeing what's on my iPhone, maybe got some inspiration on what apps you could also have. So yeah, if you want to see more what's my iPhone videos, I've already made like 5 or 10 previous ones, so I will link them in the description. I asked her to say something to you guys. Hey!
Hey! Okay.
What's on my iPhone?
iPhone right now.
Ebba is on my iPhone right now.
Yeah, I'm on your iPhone. Hello.
This is what's on my iPhone.
Nice to meet you all.
Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye.